Hello students, in last class I have discussed some question based on practical problems in your exercise 6.5. Now in continuation of the same, some more question I am going to attend today. Now first I am going to start with the question number 22, which is: of all the closed cylindrical cans of a given volume 100 cm cube, find the dimension of a can which has minimum surface area. So here two things is being discussed. First of all, volume is already given to you for a cylindrical can, and regarding the maxima evolution of your regarding the minima evolution of the surface area, we will talk about the dimension. Dimension, that means what your R will be and what your H will be. So first of all, let's start with the given parameter, that is, let radius of, or in combined form also you can decide, let radius and height of a cylindrical can are small r and h respectively, with volume v and surface area capital S. So first of all, your volume is given as a 100 centimeter cube. Volume of the cylinder we are knowing as a pi r square h. So here this volume we will write as pi r square h, that is 100 centimeter cube. From here, because it will be required afterwards, so from here h is to be separated out in terms of r. Normally what we do in such type of question, the whole question or one relation we will turn in a one variable system. So here also the same we are going to do. So h will be 100 upon pi r square. This we will mark as first equation. Now you have to talk about the minimum evolution of the surface area. So surface area of the cylinder, here you will write is S, that is 2 pi r square plus 2 pi r h. Now here this h you will substitute by using equation 1. So here this will be turned as 2 pi r square plus 2 pi r, what the h is, 100 upon pi r square. This we have written by using equation first. Now here make some cancellation. So this pi pi will cut, 1 r will also cut. So we rewrite this term as 2 pi r square plus this 200 upon r. Here you can see the whole expression or the whole formula we have turned in form of r, that is a variable one, pi is being a constant quantity. So this you can express as a function in terms of r for further better handling. Now it is to be differentiate and find out r for your minima or maxima solution. So let's differentiate with respect to r over here. So what will you get? As a first derivation, f dash r you will have s 2 pi already available. This will give you 2 r as a differentiation of a r square. Here 1 upon r is being written. So on differentiation, this will give you minus 1 upon r square. So make it somewhat sort out for evaluation of r solution. So this is the first derivative we are having. Now we will go for evaluation of r first, and then we will check whether it will give you maxima and minima for a evaluated r value. So for maxima or minima, F dash r we will take as a 0. So this is 4 pi r minus 200 upon r square, we will take it as 0. This 200 r we shift over there for separation of your r term. So now here this will be cut. Here you make it to multiply, that will be pi r cube upon 50. So this way r cube will be separated out as 50 by pi, and here r you can write as 50 upon pi with power 1 upon 3. So this is a one parameter or dimension we have evaluated in terms of a constant quantity. Now first of all, regarding this r value, you will check whether it will give you maxima or minima at this derived value, and then we will go for evaluation of this h. So our next step is what the first derivative we are having, it is to be further derived for checking of its maxima and minima evaluation. So this h only I am writing here aside, because afterwards it will be required, 100 upon pi r square, it will be required afterwards, so I make it aside. Now as your first derivative you are having is four pi r minus 200 upon r square. Now it is to be differentiate second time. So differentiate with respect to r. So second derivation, this will give you 4 pi minus 200. Differentiation of 1 upon r square will give you minus 2 upon r cube. That derivation all you aware about. Now make it multiply. This is 400 upon r cube. R cube you can substitute here. R cube already we have written 50 upon pi. So this pi will be in what? This is 4 pi plus, this will be cancelled 8 times, and this pi will be also inverse. So finally here we are having 12 pi, which is a positive quantity. And at this r is equal to 50 upon pi, you are getting this double derivative as a positive quantity. That means you can say that at this r value derived in form of pi and constant, your surface area will be minimum. So here we can conclude that as f double dash r is greater than 0 at r is equal to 50 upon pi with power 1 upon 3, therefore surface area is minimum. Now r already we have found it out. Now we have to go for evaluation of h, that is the second dimension for your cylindrical can. So now we will move towards evaluation of your height with reference to derive r value. As r we were having 50 upon pi with power 1 upon 3. Now we will go for evaluation of a height of a cylinder. So h it was 100 upon pi r square. Now this r we will substitute here. This is 100 upon pi. R square means 50 upon pi with power 2 by 3. Now the power of pi and this numerical value we have to adjust. This 100 we can split as a 2 into 50. Here also this pi and 50 with power 2 by 3 you can make a split, and this pi also you can make a split as a power 2 by 3. So here power of the pi you will adjust and this power of 50 will adjust over here. So this will be 2 into 50. This is carrying power 1. It will be go up, means minus it will be. Here also the same, 1 minus 2 upon 3. Go for taking LCM. This will be 50. 3 minus 2 means 1 by 3. Here also the same. This is 1 by 3. So these two can be combined with the fractional form with the common power. This is pi with power 1 by 3. So this is the H you are having in terms of a constant quantity. So R means the radius of the cylinder you will have is 50 upon pi with power 1 by 3, whereas height is being derived is twice of 50 upon pi with power 1 by 3. Here one more thing you can relate in terms of H and R, that H is a twice of the radius. So that also interrelation may be asked to you in a question form. So these are the two dimensions for your given cylindrical can. Radius is this much with this height. These all questions are the most important questions from examination point of view. And if you have attended some question, it will be clear to you that method in all the questions is same, but what the informations are available to you, these are different ones. So your question formation is going to be changed. But the method of evaluation everywhere remain same. So the next question we are going to attend is question number 22. That is also one of the important form, in which a wire of length 28 meter is to be cut into two pieces. One of the pieces is to be made in square form and the another into a circle. Means we are having a wire of 28 meter long. It is to be cut in two parts, and with the help of the one part you will make a square, and with the help of the another part, second part, you will form a circle. Now what should be the length of the two pieces so that the combined area of the square and the circle is minimum? So here we have to talk about their minimum area evaluation. So first of all, try to define your question in terms of the respective side. So here first, wire length available to us is 28 meter. It is to be cut into two parts, from which two shapes, means one square and one circles, are to be generated. Now first of all we have to define the length regarding this square. How much length it is going to be covered here? Obviously for a square somewhat side length we have to suppose. So let it be that side of a square form is x. As we are talking about a length, means here we have to talk about the perimeter of a square. So if you talk about the perimeter of the square, it will be your 4x. Means this much length is required to frame a square from 28 meter long wire from the first piece. Now secondly, for the remaining we are going to generate a circle. So for circle, what the length is available to us is 28 minus 4x. Already 4x we have used to frame a square, so remaining out of 28 will be used to frame a circle. So it will be considered as a circumference of a circle. So let radius of the circle be 28 minus 4x. So circumference of circle, it is what? 2πr. In our case, circumference means how much length we are going to cover with the help of second piece, and that is our 28 minus 4x. So this circumference 2πr, you can compare with the 28 minus 4x, means these two lengths are the same. Now from here r we are going to make separate out, so r will be 28 minus 4x upon 2 pi. Somewhat make it solve. 1 upon pi you make a separate. Make it divide by 2. So it is 14 minus 2x. So this is the radius of the circle what we are going to frame with the help of the second wire piece. Now we have to talk about the total area and its minimum evolution. So here, area of a square and a circle. So sum of these two we will write. Area of the square you will write as x square plus area of the circle is pi r square. R already you have defined in terms of x. So here you will go for, that is x square pi r square, that means 1 upon pi square. 14 minus 2x, it's a whole square. Here pi pi will cut. So x square 1 upon pi, 14 minus 2x whole square will remain with you. Here you can see both the terms are carrying your variable as x. So in place of the area, this expression you can define as a function in terms of x for further handling. So here we make it as a function in terms of x. Now again the process will remain same. Go for first derivation. So differentiation with respect to x. Here what we have to find out? The length of the wire. That means 4x and 28 minus 4x. So first of all we have to find out x, and for that purpose we are going to move. First derivative, that means it is 2x. Here it is 1 upon pi. With respect to power it is 2, 14 minus 2x. Here minus 2x is available, that means as a multiple minus 2 will also come. This is your 2x, 2 and 2 means minus 4 upon pi and 14 minus 2x. Now from here your x will be separate out on comparison of f dash x with the 0 for maxima and minima evaluation. So the next step is for maxima or minima, f dash x you will put as 0. So here this is the expression, we have to put it 0. Make them shift towards that side. This is cut. X 2 upon pi 14 minus 2x. From here x is to be separate out. Now x, this is 28 upon pi minus 4 x upon pi. Now this 4 x upon pi shift over there. X terms are to be combined. 28 upon pi. Go for taking LCM. That is pi x plus 4 x upon pi. This is 28 upon pi. Pi, pi will cut. X is taken common. So this is 4 plus pi, 28. So x you will come out is 28 upon 4 plus pi. So this is the x length means side of the square what you are going to be generate with the help of first piece of wire. Now it was not required actually. 4x is the finally length of the first piece, but before that we have to check that for this x your area is maximum or minimum. So now we have to move for the second derivation. So as we are having f dash x is 2x minus 4 upon pi 14 minus 2x. Differentiate second time. F double dash x, this will be 2 minus 4 upon pi. This will be differentiate. So finally it will give you your minus 2 only. So this is your 2 minus minus plus 8 upon pi. Here you can see this quantity is a positive quantity. And S double dash is positive quantity. So at the derived value for x, this will the area will give you the minimum solution. So here is f double dash x is greater than 0. That means area is a minimum. Now we have to go for evaluation of 4x and 28 minus 4x. So dimension, or you can say the length of the two pieces are 4x. What the x? 28 upon 4 plus pi. This is to be multiplied. This will give you 112 4 plus pi. So this is the length of first piece. Second, length of second piece. That will be 28 minus 4x means that was the circumference for the circle. So that will be 28 minus 4x. 4x already we have written here. 4 plus pi. Go for taking LCM. 28, 4 plus pi minus 112. Make them multiply. These two will cut. 28 pi upon 4 plus pi. So this is the length of the second piece. So this way first piece will be with this length and the second one will have this much length. So this way 28 meter wire is to be cut with these two required lengths to frame a square and a circle in such a way that their sum of the area turn as a minimum solution. This is also an important form. Now we are going to discuss question number 24, in which the informations are available as: show that the right circular cone of least curved surface and given volume has an altitude equal to under root 2 times of the radius of its base. Now what the question is, we are having a cone with given height and base radius. This is your right circular cone with height h base radius this much and the slant height L. Now its volume is available to you, means volume is having its fixed value that is not given to you, but direct as a volume we will consider as a V, and having the least curved surface area. Curved surface area of the cone we know as a pi r L. Okay, so here first of all we write given volume of cone V is equal to 1 upon 3 pi r square h. From here h we are going to make a separate as 3V upon pi r square. This we will treat as a first relation. Now we have to talk about the least curved surface area. That means surface area you will define here, and for its minimum solution you will discuss the solution here. So first of all, curved surface area of cone that is S will be pi r l. Here both the side we are going to make a square to make a solution easy. Now L square here we can define as R square plus H square. So that only you will substitute over here. Pi square, R square, R square plus H square. H already you have defined in the equation number first. So using equation first, S square you can write as pi square, R square, R square plus H square means square of this one, that will be 9V square upon pi square and R power 4. Insert this pi square I square inside the function, that will be pi square R power 4 plus 9, pi square will cut, V square upon R square. You can see this whole function in terms of a R only, where V is constant. So this you can define as function in terms of R. Now it is to be differentiate. So FR we are having is pi square R4 plus 9V square upon R square. It is to be proceed for first differentiation with respect to R. So F dash R here you will have is 4 pi square r cube. Here this will give you minus 9 into 2 v square upon r cube. This is to be sort out for your r solution. So for maxima and minima, f dash r substitute is 0, that is your 4 r cube minus 18 v square upon r 3 is equal to 0. Shift over there. Here make it cancel it out. So this is your 4 pi square r cube r 6 we can generate 18. V from here you can substitute here as a 1 upon 9 pi square r 4 and h square. Here you can see pi square cut. This is 2 za. From here it is 2 time. R4 it is 2 times. So what the relation we have generated, 2R square is equal to H square, or here you can say H is equal to under root 2R. Now for this relation you will check out whether your second derivative is positive or negative. As first derivation we have written is 4 pi square r cube minus 18 v square upon r 3. Now make it differentiate further. So differentiate with respect to r. F double dash r, that will give you 12 pi square r square. Now here this will give you 18 into minus 3 v square upon r 4. If you look at this all solution, minus minus plus. Here, all terms are the square one, means with the even combination. So, any of the value you are going to substitute here, this will give you a positive solution, means it is a greater than zero quantity. So, here you can say that at h is equal to under root 2r, curved surface area is minimum. So for minimum evaluation, altitude of this cone is under root 2 times of radius of your cone. So this way, this is a different type of questions you can handle. Thank you.